2,000 years ago, an event occurred on the far side of the world that changed Ireland forever. The life and death of a little-known Jewish prophet gave birth to a religion that banished the old gods and the old way of life. Christianity. Fabulous temples were erected to this new god, and secrets were hewn in their stones. Now, cutting-edge science, graphics, and archaeology unravel the enigma of Ireland's most iconic Christian sites. The mysterious Skellig Michael. The medieval powerhouse, Clonmacnoise. And Mellifont Abbey, the Cistercian success story. Using state-of-the-art technology to uncover their true history. It's a story that has defined us to this day. Over 1,500 years ago, our ancestors suddenly changed everything they believed and shaped our destiny. They constructed soaring monuments to a new god. They created utterly unique works of art and architecture, initiating a new way of worship. Their sheer artistry placed Irish monks on the world stage. But where did it begin? And why did it seem to happen so peacefully?
There seems to have been a famine caused by we know not what.
There are gaps in our history that have never been explained.
It may well have caused the wholesale Christianization of Ireland.
Science and archaeology come together to challenge the accepted story.
And coming around the monastery, that's a suspicious looking bend.
And turn Ireland's early history upside down.
Everybody knows that Patrick brought Christianity to Ireland. Everybody is wrong.
Can an extraordinary new discovery shine light on Ireland's dark ages? And finally, give us some answers. But exactly when Ireland became fully Christian, and why, unlike Europe, it changed religion so peacefully, is a mystery. Incredibly, it's a mystery that Danish climatologists drilling ice cores on the Greenland ice sheet may have found an answer to.
When we drill an ice core in Greenland, then usually we drill all the way to bedrock, and that is 3 kilometers of ice. So we have an archive that is 3 kilometers long, and then we will, for many purposes, simply take the ice and slice it like a salami.
The ice core archive is an atmospheric fingerprint. Trapped inside the cores are tiny bubbles of the Earth's atmosphere, stretching back 150,000 years. It can tell us exactly when climate changes occur and why. Glaciologist Bo Vinther discovered a 6th-century event which had a colossal impact on the Earth's atmosphere. An event expressed in the records of the time.
This has been described in historical evidence as a period of famine and a period of a dimmed sun, and therefore, of course, we were very curious to see if there was any evidence for this in the ice cores.
In fact, the records tell us that something extremely dramatic happened in the year 536 AD. The densest dry fog on record was observed across Europe all the way to the Middle East. But what was it? Bohr found samples of sulfuric acid in the atmosphere for a period of 9 years. It led to only one conclusion.
This has all the fingerprints that we would like to see for a volcanic eruption. The magnitude of this eruption is unknown to us as modern human beings because it is so big that we haven't really experienced it before and have no good data for what will happen.
The effects of such an eruption are catastrophic. Massive quantities of silicate ash and sulfur are ejected into the stratosphere. A veil of dust forms around the Earth. The Earth's temperature rapidly plummets, and it can last for years. The tree ring records tell the same story. Over 10 years ago, dendrochronologist Mike Bailey spotted the exact same anomaly.
Starts in 536 and runs on for about a decade to the middle of the 540s. And it's extremely severe as far as the trees are concerned. Some of the trees are actually damaged in Ireland. But then we discovered that this event also shows up in trees right across Eurasia. It's in Europe, it's in Siberia, it's Mongolia. It is the worst growth event that you come to in the last 2,000 years.
In Ireland, the crops failed. The trees withered. People starved, grew ill, and died. And the new Roman god, Christ, had barely a foothold in a land that worshipped nature. It's not difficult to imagine how those that survived interpreted the event.
People at that point could be taking this as a sign that that they had done something wrong, or they were being punished, or that in some way had, you know, stirred the gods.
Is it possible that a volcano on the far side of the world terrified people into changing their religion?
I wouldn't be at all surprised that it really did cause the wholesale Christianization of Ireland as one of its effects.
Could it even explain why Christianity flourished in the 6th century? From 540 onwards, a new era was ushered in. Christian saints spread across the country, founding breathtaking monasteries dedicated to worshipping their new god. Irish monasticism began its golden age.